Hey everybody, so it's no secret that one of my favorite things to do is shop, and I've just got back from a really cool winter market in Estoril, which is this beachside community about 40 minutes outside of Lisbon by train. And in this winter market were all brands that are made in Portugal or by Portuguese designers, and I have just been really surprised and excited since my time here in Lisbon of discovering these really unique, high aesthetic, really cool Portuguese brands. So in this video today, I want to take you along with me on this trip to the winter market and also tell you about some of the designers that I've discovered here and some of the things that I've bought. All right, so first, let's head to the winter market. To Estoril for a market of all products that are made here in Portugal. When I was shopping the other day at this store called Isto in Lisbon, the sales girl, who was really sweet, told me about this market, which is just today and yesterday. And so I thought, why not? I have nothing else to do on a Sunday. It sounds like a great idea. And so far, everything that I've seen that's made in Portugal of these brands has been really, really cool stuff, including even this hat that I bought yesterday from, I think the brand is actually just called Plus351, which is the country code for Portugal. And so I'm almost there. I took the train from Lisbon that goes to Cascais. Oh my God, this Porsche right here, this vintage Porsche. I know I'm in the right town because I've already seen a Bentley, this vintage Porsche. It's so chic. This must be like an upscale kind of beach community for rich people who don't want to live in Lisbon. It almost kind of feels like the Malibu of Portugal. And yeah, this place is also famous because there's a tennis ATP 250 event that happens here each year. That's how I already knew the name Estoril. And yeah, so I'm just walking up to this place. I can actually see it right in front of me, called Feiril. And it's gonna be a cool day. Let's go explore. Love this grandpa sweater. Look at that. That's such a vintage pattern on that. I love the color, not so much the pattern, but it's also super soft. So I'm trying on this sweater in a size small, and I think it's pretty fabulous. It fits me great. It has such a nice rolled, relaxed shoulder, which just makes it super effortless and cozy. And I just think it looks really nice. It even is kind of perfect with the jeans that I'm wearing. I keep buying stuff here in Lisbon and in Portugal because the handicraft work and the artisanship is just so nice, and the price is actually quite reasonable, 163 euros for this sweater, which feels like pure wool, and I actually think it could be hand knit. Let's ask. So I've just learned this is 100% merino wool. It's not hand knit, it's machine knit, but still so nice, and again, for this price, I think that's really fair, and love that this is the designer, this is her mom, 100% made in Portugal. I love these books. Look at this, everything is so chic, minimalist, so cute. I already bought a book for my Portuguese classes that start tomorrow to write all of my notes, but if I didn't, I would totally, oh my God, so cool, I would totally buy these. Look how gorgeous this is too. Merci. Au revoir. I'm quite happy because I actually haven't eaten all day today. It's now 2 o'clock. And so I stopped by Madame Gofte, and I got a great traditional Belgian snack, a sweet waffle. And it's just the perfect thing because it's freshly made. It's nice and warm and it gives me the energy to walk around this fabulous market. I'm having such a lovely afternoon. I'm so glad I came here. I think that I had already seen these candles at Embaixada, but look at how cute they are. If I actually had my house already, I would buy a bunch of these very adorable circle, spherical, like, I don't know, Rubik's cubes candles, and just so chic. Look at how beautiful that is. So I'm back to now actually the brand that brought me here. Again, this is called Isto, and they have a shop in Lisbon close by to where I'm staying, and I was in there, and again, the girl who's helping somebody, but she's back there, she's the one who told me to come to this winter market. And again, I love all the stuff. Super perfect basics, things that you wear forever and ever, just like again and again, that never go out of style because they're so classic. And you can tell, being that they're made here in Portugal, it's really well done, high quality, just lovely. Check out how gorgeous these are. These are beach towels made in Portugal, and they're so chic. Absolutely beautiful. You can use this probably as a blanket too, or like a throw in your house. It's so nice. Look at how gorgeous these are, these beach towels. So pretty. The colors, the patterns, the quality. Oh my god, so nice. Actually, I may buy this just because it's too pretty not to. Okay, so correction, these actually are blankets, not beach throws. The beach throws are on the other side, but they're having a 30% off deal on them, and I think that they are marked to, let's see, 60 euros. Let's check. 60 euros and 30% off, that's actually quite significant. Then it's only like 45 euros for this blanket. And it's so chic, it's so nice. I'm kind of thinking about already how I'm gonna decorate my home in Portugal, even though I don't really have a home yet. Yeah, so I'm buying this towel, 30% off, and it's so, no, not towel, blanket, and it's just so adorable. I love it. I love the color, so classic. And it's made here in Portugal, right?
Yes.
100% cotton.
100% cotton, yeah.
Beautiful. What's the name of this brand?
Irundo.
Irundo.
Irundo, it's Latin for swallow.
For swallow?
Yeah, swallow the bird.
It's all made from recycled materials in Portugal, right?
No, they're all sustainable, but okay. For instance, this is recycled pork. You have pork there,
right,
at the bottom. And we use two types of leather, normal leather, and this leather, it's aniline. It's the same leather that they used to use to produce the old school leather gloves.
Okay.
Because the gold's like, now they're comfortable, you wear them for like 2-3 days tops, and the leather breaks in and molds your feet.
Oh, nice.
It's like a glove.
They seem like they would be comfortable.
Yeah, they are comfortable. You see everything is hand-stitched, even there at the bottom, you see all the stitching?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, beautiful. Do you have them in a 40?
Which one?
I kind of like this blue.
The blue one. Let me check.
So I really love these shoes. I'm not sure if I like more the one with the blue sole or the dark gray black sole, which one I might get more use out of. But I'm also having this inner dialogue right now of how many sneakers I have, and do I really need another pair, and if so, they should be different from what I already have. I've decided to take the shoes for 145 euros. I think it's honestly a good deal considering they are leather, hand-stitched, made here in Portugal. I'm so happy to be at this fair, and it's all Portuguese brands. You know, to support local and to shop local, I think, is one of the most important things that we can do in terms of the environment and in terms of just a good society as well. So again, just super impressed with these Portuguese brands, the level of creativity, the aesthetic, the craftsmanship, all of that. So thus far, I have had an absolutely fantastic afternoon shopping here, buying things all for myself. All right, so I've actually just come back from the winter market, and that's when I'm recording this video, as I left because it had started raining and it's still pretty gray and overcast right now, so perfect for recording this video. Now I want to tell you about some of the different things that I've bought since I've been here in Portugal, and some of the other designers that I've discovered, things that I really like. So starting with this shirt that I'm wearing, which is from a brand called Isto. Now this is a shop that I just walked by on one of my walks home. They're in the Baixa Chiado area, and what caught my eye even from the store window is just like everything was really neutral and it looked really cute. So I go inside and I love immediately the aesthetic of just really beautiful classic pieces that are high quality, made here in Portugal. So this shirt that I bought, I fell in love with as soon as I put it on because it's made from 100% cotton fleece. It just feels so incredibly luxurious and cozy, and the fit was perfect for me. Again, actually, I'm really surprised since I've been here. I'm quite small. Like in Asia, it's not a problem, but usually when I would clothing shop in like America, I would always have a problem because I'm too little. But here in Portugal, I actually fit a size small pretty well. So that's another bonus. People in Portugal tend not to be like the tallest in Europe. And again, great for me and for clothing buying. So another thing that I bought from that same shop was a beanie, because it is a bit cold here and I didn't have anything like that. I don't want to put it on and mess up my hair. But also from the winter fair, as you guys saw, I bought this Marinière, very classic French style shirt. Very cute, perfect for wearing with jeans or whatever. Just, I didn't have anything like this, and it's such a classic piece that pretty much everybody should have in their wardrobe. So for 60 euros, I thought, really good buy. Also, this shirt was about, I think, 95 euros. So they're reasonably priced considering, you know, made here ethically, sustainably in Portugal. Now, one of the very first things that I bought when I got here, I went to a shopping area called Embaixada, which is so chic. I wholeheartedly recommend visiting, because it's like a restored old palace, basically, and they've made it into all of these different shops selling Portuguese designers and things like that. So from this store, which is called Chumeco, they have all authentic Portuguese shoes, and I went in there and I immediately gravitated towards these amazing boots. Now, this is from a brand called Lemon Jelly, again, designed and manufactured here in Portugal from actually recycled rubber. So again, sustainably made. That seems to be a really big focus of designers here in Portugal, the sustainability, the ethics, etc., which is fantastic. So these actually, despite the fact that I think that they look super expensive, I think they were about 99 euros. And they're so comfortable. I wore them on the 8-hour hike in Sintra, and I've worn them all around these cobblestones, and I get so many compliments on them. They're so fabulous, and the fact that they're rubber makes it perfect for when it's a bit rainy like today, you know, to still be out and not ruin your shoes. So love those. And lastly, because I think I've showed you everything else that I bought today from the winter market, I just want to plug this other brand called Plus351. This is a shop that I discovered in the Santos area, and it's kind of like a surf lifestyle shop, just again, really high quality basics. And I loved this cotton terry cloth long sleeve shirt. Again, you can see the Plus351. So Plus351 is the country calling code for Portugal. I like the fact that the branding is really minimal, and it's kind of like you have to be in the know to even know what Plus351 is. So loved this because it's super cozy, great for at home, or if you're going to the beach when it's like in the fall season like now and you just need a layer on top. Again, terry cloth, so great for that kind of environment, and just again, the hat, classic but also really chic. So love that. And yeah, as I've said, so many amazing Portuguese brands and designers that I'm discovering here. Again, it makes me feel really excited about my decision to move to Portugal and the opportunities to create and to manufacture here, which, as I've said many times, if you guys know my videos, is one of the best things about Bali, is the artisanship there. So I'm seeing a very high level of sophistication and craftsmanship here in Portugal. Again, just makes me so excited for all the possibilities of things that I could do once I move here and get things going. Anyway, that's it for this video. Thank you guys for following along. Until the next time, take care, and I'll see you later.